sarar och klara som en dag. Hur skall man det besinna? När det blir va gifta blir det skräp ändå. Sällan vill det vara hemma.
So I've arrived at Arlanda Airport in Stockholm. And the temperature out here is minus 17 degrees Celsius, which is very cold. Okay, I think at that temperature the laws of physics start to break down and time goes backwards and mass turns to energy and stuff. But it is very cold. I've never known any of these cultures, I don't think. Here comes the Arlanda Express to Stockholm.
Central Station, and we want to take this opportunity to welcome you to Stockholm.
So I've arrived in central Stockholm, and good news, it's warmed up. It's only minus 7. Gosh, I think I'll get the sun cream out. So as luck would have it, I've checked into the hotel. I'm in the Scandic Continental, and well, my hotel's on, my room's on the top floor. That's floor 12. And the glass, I don't know if you can see it. It's one of those that slants forwards. And that, yeah, that's snow. That's what you get at minus 7 degrees. But lovely view though. So here I am in Stockholm, just about to go across there to the old city. You can see there, hopefully off in the distance, the Parliament and the King's Palace as well. I don't know the name of the King or the Prime Minister actually. I think she is still the Prime Minister. She changed her mind a couple of times recently. Let's go. Been asked what are Swedish people like, and the answer came back, well look, put it like this. If you're looking at a queue in a bus stop, how do you know which one of the people queuing up are Swedes? And the answer is, the Swedish people are the ones who are standing the furthest apart. And I think that gives you two unique insights. One into how distant the Swedish people are and how far apart they live because it's such a rural country. But also what their sense of humour is like. So I'm now in the old city part of Stockholm, And how do I know, you might ask? How do I know that I am in the old city part? Well, you can just see the paving's kind of cobbly. And yeah, just gotta watch where you're going, especially with the ice and snow. So this is the famous Leaning House of Stockholm. No, I'd not heard of it either. And I think this is the office coming up on the left. Oh, here we are. Okay. Wonder if anyone's in. So this here, this is the oldest bank in the world. Who knew? And I'm guessing this sculpture is, or statue is, of a man who is a banker. Okay. And I think it's shut. And no, there's no cash machine either. Bother. I've had a little walk around the old part of Stockholm, and now I'm walking back across it's basically the Baltic Sea, I guess. It's difficult to convey in human terms that are understandable to somebody living in the southern part of the United of England exactly how cold it actually is here, in that there is snow on the ground and it's not going anywhere because it's just frozen in to ice and it's just gonna sit there, and you've got the wind coming across the sea and it's freezing. But hey, you got a pretty palace that's sort of lit up in red. And every now and again, if we walk closely and we hold our breaths and say a nice little prayer, maybe, just maybe, the red colour will change to a different colour. Yeah. Oh, something's happening. Look at that. Sing-so. This city is full of surprises. Okay. A little lost. I'm on the corner of what the heck is that road called? And this one will be easier to pronounce. Obviously not. It's very prissy though. But oh my, is it cold? And this magnificent building is what I came to see. It's the Great Synagogue of Stockholm. Let's see what we can get inside. Quite a remarkable building. It is actually closed, as you'd probably expect. It's a reform synagogue, didn't know that. Or Masorti, as they say. Well, it's form stroke Masorti. But what an impressive building it is, and what a fascinating statue that is outside. I'm now in the more modern bit of Stockholm, downtown, in where all the shops are and stuff. And as you can possibly see, the shops seem to be selling a lot of warm clothes. And heaven help them, they certainly need it. But oh my goodness, what on earth? Okay, what kind of a photo? I mean, I know babies are difficult to pose at the best of times, but you wouldn't want that on the front of your shop, would you? So I'm on this road called Meiksmuelsmangusgarden or something, and wow, look how beautiful this is! Isn't it pretty? Let's go and have a look. Look, we've got this massive thing. What's that place down there? Sandwich bar. Do you get it? It's sandwich bar. Or maybe you can't see it. It's sandwich bar, but because we're in Scandinavia, they've called it Scandwich. Very funny. Here we have the flagship store of H&M. One of Sweden's retail success stories. You'll notice that the colour scheme on the clothes is rather limited. This is the Swedish principle of lagom, which means everything in just about the right measure. Everything should be just about average. Right, this is a bit weird. I have no idea what this is. It's called reaction video. Whoa. Yeah, it's like, wow. Look at that. Unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to get over to see what could have promised to be the highlight of my trip, and that was the ABBA Museum. Due to conflicting logistical arrangements, it's just not going to be possible. And that's a bit sad, actually, because ABBA's got to be one of Sweden's greatest assets, greatest exports, greatest contributions to the music industry, obviously excluding Swedish House Mafia and Ace of Base, but you know, we can argue on those. Yeah. So it's 5:30 in the morning, and I'm getting on a train to leave Stockholm and go over to Gothenburg. The temperature out here is -4, so a bit of a heat wave, actually. So in light of recent uptick in COVID cases and the new Omicron variant COVID, Sweden has imposed a new change of restrictions that mean that anyone in public or in a public space like a station on public transport has to wear a mask. Yeah, as you can see, Swedes have a healthy disregard for rules. So, we're here in Gothenburg, and it might not look like it, but it's actually quite a bit different from Stockholm. It's got similarities in some ways, but the snow for one. But it's a lot more of an industrialized town, or city, I should say. Whereas Stockholm's more got an economy based on high tech. But still, nonetheless, beautifully lit up.
I walked down the street and I saw a guy with a kippah on the head. So I didn't know what to scream to him. I was going, "You there!" I screamed, "Chag Sameach!" And we're just waiting for Razel to finish in the makeup shop. Then we're taking Jeff?
Phil.
Sorry. Phil home for dinner. So Phil, what do you eat today?
So I've had a banana.
And guys, it's snowing again and Mendel doesn't want his hood.
This is the coldest snow I've ever seen. Yeah, you're right.
You have snow in London at all?
We get wimpy snow. We don't get piles like this.
No.
We don't get anything like this. So this is the shore. Up. And
you see the mug and dad on the reef?
Okay.
Beautiful dragon.
Wow. Yeah.
It's right on the thing.
And these are some new friends that I bumped into. Sorry, I'm Phil Cohen.
Danny Numner.
Danny Numner, nice to meet you. And how's Danny Numner Jr.?
Mendel.
Mendel. Hello! The one with the amazing smile.
So we put Phil straight away, straight to work.
So this is the Chabad house in Gothenburg. And apparently all the shluchim from around Europe come here. Wow.
You know why he's helping and popping, guys?
I've just slapped the menorah up the hill. Oh, look at this.
Hi. Did you expect to see Jews?
Well, I didn't know there were any Jews in the whole of Sweden, to be honest with you. I thought they were all Vikings.
To see what I've walked into. Thank you very much. Yeah, L'chaim.
You need a L'chaim.
L'chaim. Well, so the moral of the story is always be proud to be Jewish, always wear your yarmulke when you're out, and keep kosher as well.